Hey YouTube, welcome back. This is going to be my second video on my 20-gallon Nano Reef setup. Hopefully today I'll be able to get the live sand in the tank, the protein skimmer up and running, and get some active carbon inside the power filter. But before we get started in there, I'm just going to look at one little problem I'm having. Nothing too serious, and I think I have a solution for it already. If we walk up to the tank here, you look around the top, you can see that I've lost about 3/4 of an inch to an inch of water due to evaporation. It's only been about 5 days. So I did purchase a VersaTop to put on top of this. Hopefully help mitigate the evaporation. So I'll get that on today too and see what that looks like. Alright, so let's get started looking at the sand. Alright, getting started with the sand, I chose to go with Carib Sea Agro Live Sand. It is the Fiji Pink brand that they offer. So the granules inside of it should be about 0.5 millimeters to 1.5 millimeters. So it's a pretty fine sand, which is good because it'll have a lot of surface area. It is a live sand. I decided to go with live instead of inert because it just comes with all these great elements and a lot of beneficial bacteria. So hopefully it'll help cycle the tank a little quicker. On the front of this bag here, you can see there's a lot of information on it. And since it is a live sand, I should be able to just drop this bag right into the aquarium and not have to rinse it or anything like that. So let's get in the tank and we'll talk a little bit more about it. Okay, real quick, before I get the sand in, I want to make sure I turn off my power head and my power filter, just so I can let the sand settle on the bottom of the tank without any water flow, mixing it up and keeping it suspended in there. Okay, as you can see, I got the sand in the aquarium. This is pretty much right after I put the sand in, so the water's gonna be pretty foggy for a while. So we'll give it a couple hours to a day, 2 days, and see what it looks like at those time periods. Okay, so this is about 9 hours since I put the sand in this morning. It's still pretty foggy in there, but at least we can see the power head pretty clear now, and you can start to see the inlet to the power filter. So it is clearing up. Hopefully after a good 24 hours or so, it'll look a lot better than this. Alright, this is about 48 hours after the sand was put in the tank. As you can see, everything's settled and it's looking pretty nice. We'll walk up and take a quick look around. So the glass needs to be cleaned off up front here, but now we will get the protein skimmer up and running. Okay, here's the protein skimmer we talked about in the first video. It has been installed in the back of the aquarium, but hasn't been running. I was waiting to get the sand in there. So now I am going to plug her in, get her started, and make sure there's no leaks, and we'll talk a little bit more about it then. Get started, water's reaching the top level here, and spilling back into the aquarium. This here is a view from behind the aquarium under the power filter. You can see the bottom of the skimmer, and no leaks so far, so we're good there. Here, this is the nozzle where you can adjust the amount of air that gets into the pump and creates the bubbles within the pump. So over the next couple days, I'll probably be tuning that and trying to get it to an area where I like it and try and create the finest micro bubbles that we can. Alright. Okay, for the final part of this video, I'm just going to get the active carbon cartridges into the power filter. This back here just pops off. And you can see the slots for the carbon cartridges. Now all you have to really do is make sure that you insert the cartridges right side up and blue side facing the back. Right, there you can see the carbon cartridges are in place. And hopefully the water will start clearing up a little bit more from that. One more thing here real quick. I mentioned the VersaTop I purchased in the beginning of the video. Well, here it is installed in the tank. You can see the water condensating on the other side of that, so hopefully it's helping with the evaporation. It's only been on there for about a day or two, so we shall see the effects of this in the next video, hopefully. Okay, YouTube, this pretty much concludes this video. I have the sand in the tank, the protein skimmer up and running, and the active carbon cartridges inside the power filter. So we'll take a look around real quick and talk about the next video. So hopefully this weekend I'm going to purchase the live rock and get it here by Tuesday. And then I can start filling the tank with the live rock. I have to wait for that to cure, so that's going to be a bit of a process there. Hopefully I can make a few videos in between the curing process. I'll also, I guess, get my power head back up and run. I turned that off for now. It's blowing the sand around too much, so I figured I'll get a piece of live rock in there to diffuse the power head from hitting the sand, or maybe aim it differently, but for right now, there's really no purpose in having it up and running. So hopefully by next week, I will have the live rock in there and another video to put up. All right, thanks for watching.